problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
Hey guys, Mike Heller. I shot a lot of 35mm on the ground working for the newspaper, but I was also a flight instructor, commercial pilot, had a little airplane, and I shot a lot of aerials. So when it came to making aerials, I settled on a medium format camera. I had a high performance airplane. It was fast. I was covering news events. Here's the riot at the penitentiary of New Mexico in 1980. I was up in the mountains shooting aerials, shooting scenics, and I was traveling fast close to the ground. I could shoot 35mm at a thousandth of a second out of the airplane, and those images were sharp. They worked out fine, but I couldn't blow them up big enough. I tried a Hasselblad, but it just wasn't comfortable. I didn't like where the shutter button was, the 500th of a second shutter wasn't fast enough, and I'd have to get a special viewfinder to use it in the plane. And I never liked the square format for negatives or for prints. So for shooting aerials, I settled on a 6x7 Pentax, which is like a giant 35mm camera, has bayonet mount lenses on it, has a thousandth of a second shutter. And being so much like a 35mm camera with a thumb-wind film advance, it was just easier to transition into and easier to handle, especially since I was a one-man band flying the airplane and taking pictures both. So here's my old Domke bag on the left next to my 6x7 Tough Traveler bag on the right. I kept the shoulder strap short because I put the bag on the passenger seat and run the shoulder strap behind the seat, and then I'd have the seat belt around the bottom of it so the bag stayed in place. Here's the 6x7 Pentax next to my FM2 Nikon, significantly different size camera. So here's what I was using out of the airplane. A 6x7 Pentax, although I had that nice wooden handle over there on the right side, you can see it on top of a light meter box. That handle didn't work for me in the airplane because I was shooting out of a small window. It was fairly small opening, and I couldn't shoot through the glass. Shooting through the glass in an airplane, shooting through the plastic windows, just never works out. You really need to shoot in the open air. So in some Cessnas, it's easy to open the window and just let the window flap up high against the wing, and you have a beautiful opening to take pictures out of. On my Mooney, you just had that one little window on the pilot side that was meant for talking to guys on the ground when you're pulling up to get gas. But that little window was all that I could open. So I stuck the camera lens out the window, and my hands would be too close to the glass using that wooden handle. Let me give you a comparison of 35mm lenses to medium format lenses.
A 24mm lens on a 35mm camera is a 50mm lens on a 6x7.
And this was wide enough that if I wasn't careful, either I'd get part of the propeller or part of the wing and the side of my wide-angle pictures.
And then my normal lens was the one that's on the camera here now, and that's 105mm. See it in there. And then I also had a 200mm and that big piece of glass over there, which is a 400mm lens. So this kind of equates in 35mm comparison to having about a 28mm wide angle lens, having a 50mm normal lens, and then having a 100mm lens, and the 400mm from the 6x7 was equivalent to a 200mm lens in a 35mm setup. So in 35mm, I didn't like that 135mm lens very much, but this 200mm lens came quite a bit in handy out of the airplane because I just found myself at certain altitudes, especially taking pictures of things that were on the ground, they're happening on the ground, where that lens worked out well. The big lens, that 400mm lens, got you good close-ups, but it took a little bit of doing to get it everything set up right. I couldn't be really even at a thousandth of a second, I couldn't be really going fast close to the ground using that lens. There'd still be some blur. And that was a big piece of glass to be out in the wind, because I was moving along usually 150, 170 miles an hour. I had a couple of close-up setups. I did some work in a turquoise mine with a guy, and I wanted to shoot some larger format, and I got a macro lens and a couple of extension tubes. There's a meter for the camera. This camera will work with through the lens metering, but the meter isn't on it right now. The camera itself, see if I can do this one-handed, holding it in my lap. The lens comes off this way, and you can see the size of the mirror in it. Everything is just huge. The shutter system works on a battery, and I don't have a battery in it right now. I ordered a battery. I'll show you a sample of what this thing looks like when you press the shutter button. The meter comes up, and the shutter curtain slides from side to side across this 2¾-inch wide opening. It makes some noise, but it's flawless. It works wonderfully. So I've got the back open. You can see the shutter curtain. I'll fire the shutter here in a half a second. That's pretty noisy, eh? Now to rewind this without film in it, push down on the film counter, and then you rotate the camera while you're holding the film counter so that it comes up off of zero. See, I'm about 10 or so. And then I have to close the camera back. Then I can let go of the film counter. Now, I can wind the film. I can advance the shutter. There's no film in the camera. Now with it advanced, I can open the back of the camera again. And I'll let you see that same half a second exposure. That big old mirror moves right out of the way. Now let's do a thousandth of a second. And here's a thousandth of a second. Pretty loud. Anyway, that's the beast. It's got rollers on all sides. Roller, second roller. You slide the back plate over to go to the 220 film format, and then you adjust that up here. That changes the counter for 220 format. And again, 220 is just a double length roll of 120. This camera's seen some stuff. Medium format. So that's the setup. It's kind of like a Nikon with the bayonet mount. This mounts from this side and locks into place just like your regular 35. Sweet camera. So when do you want to use a medium format camera? Well, you can use it walking around if you're a social landscape kind of photographer, but it's just a lot to carry and it's a lot to conceal. People know you're carrying a camera when you come walking into the room with this thing. For social landscape stuff, I'd much rather use that FM2 Nikon or something similar to that, smaller camera that's you can kind of hide behind your back. Landscape stuff, this would work. This would work really well for landscapes. Buildings, I might want something that had a parallax correction ability in one of the lenses. I don't believe that Pentax makes one like that. Other general photography, travel stuff, commercial work, this gives you a nice image. Now you're competing today against you know, hundreds of megapixels and digital cameras and tremendous quality out of them, but a good medium format negative will make a spectacular 16 by 20 print. So it worked for me out of the airplane. I hardly shot any 6 by 7 stuff on the ground except some of that turquoise mine. But from the airplane, thousandth of a second shutter, easy to handle. This worked well for me.
The problem is all inside your head, she said to me.